And now you both get to demonstrate your love to one another through the vows you have chosen to say. Jaxson, do you have the ring?
Senses here in Cookeville. She spoke that entire time. I was very nervous. I spilled my chips on the floor.
Yeah, because I think he had been wanting to ask me out for like 2 years, and he was waiting. He said he had to better himself. So yeah, he asked me out for our first date, and we went like right up the road from here, and it was Seven Senses, and I remember he spilled his chips on the floor, and I probably didn't shut up the whole night because I love to talk. But it was, I knew there was going to be something special there from day one. We dated for 8 months before he proposed to me, which seems like, you know, a short amount of time. You know, a lot of times people date for, you know, multiple years at least, and we actually just celebrated our 2-year anniversary last weekend. So it does now seem like we've been dating longer. But yeah, I think everyone thought we were crazy when we got engaged, but it's like the old saying, when you know, you know. And I knew like pretty early on that I was going to marry Jaxson, so it was an easy yes for me.
Proposal's a funny story. So we went on a nature walk in Knoxville, and I had the ring with me there, and I could not work up the courage to do it there. It didn't feel right. I think she expected me to propose on that walk. I didn't do it.
I just moved to Knoxville, and I've been kind of giving him a hard time all day. Like, you know, like, why are we doing all this stuff today? Because he like took me to this park and was asking me all these questions. And I'm like, why are you asking me all these like weird questions today? And it's because he was like trying to fill me out before he asked me. And he actually ended up just asking me in my hour now kitchen in Knoxville in my apartment, because he was like, I wanted to just be me and you one-on-one. And then we did some pictures at the Biltmore.
Yeah, so we get back to the apartment, we're washing dishes, just doing normal stuff. She's still not talking to me. She's slamming the refrigerator door, and she turns back around with the bowl in her hands, and there I am on one knee. And you know what? She wasn't mad after that.
Personality, and can't wait to see what the future holds for you next. I love you always, Kelly.
And I'll just leave you with a toast from Proverbs. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Do not lean on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge Him, and He'll make your path straight. To the Pelfreys. One of the stories I gotta tell you is, you know, sometimes, Kenzie, when you marry into a family, sometimes you marry into crazy. But we're playing UALR, and there were some fans in the stands. You know, it was a good game, but you know, UALR was playing probably the best game we've had of the season, right? Well, you know, there's a couple fans over to our left that started booing at the team. And I mean, these guys, they're standing up and they're saying boo. And Miss Tracy hears them, these people booing, and I've never seen this in my life, where she starts going crazy. I mean, she's saying, "You have the audacity to boo at our fans, at our players, at our coaches. You have no idea how hard they work." And I mean, I can't say all the words that she said, but she was leaning over and goes, "You know what? If you're gonna boo at our players, I'm gonna boo at you. Boo! Boo!" And then she's like, "Oh yeah, you look over here. I'm crazy." So, you know, sometimes you marry into crazy, and that's okay. And that's okay, because you know what? Miss Tracy and John are some of the best people I've ever met. And cheers to them, some of the nicest people in the entire world. And guys, what I'm trying to get to is, you know, they have an incredible marriage and have had an incredible life together. And so, you know, you guys can look to them and see, you know what, there are so many things that they've done in their life that have been so well, and look to them as leaders and all of that through your marriage and everything like that. And so, guys, I couldn't be more happy for you. I love you so much. You know, everybody, raise your glass. To crazy.
Let me see you move. Come on. see you move.
So good.